Let us fix our eyes on Jesus. Let us take a typical example here. The book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 14. We take from verse 25. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them walking on the lake or sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I. Don't be." 28. "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the." 29. "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you?" When Peter saw Jesus walking on the water, he said, "Lord, if it is you, tell me to come," doing the same thing you are doing. He came out of the boat. His eyes were fixed on the author and the perfecter of, and he started to what? All of a sudden, there came, his eyes were now set off Jesus, but now set on thee. And when he did that, the scripture says he began to sink. The scripture says, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author, the beginning, the owner, and the perfecter, or the end of faith. Peter started very well by fixing his eyes on Jesus, and a miracle happened when his eyes were fixed on Jesus. But when he set his eyes off Jesus and set them on something else, which is not the author and the perfecter of faith, he started to sink. When you walk by faith with your eyes fixed on Jesus, thinking Jesus, looking at Jesus, and listening to what Jesus says, miracles occur in your life. The impossible becomes possible in your life. Incurable sicknesses yield to your prayer because your eyes are fixed on who? But many of us, when we see ourselves walking on the water, we now set our eyes off Jesus and begin to magnify ourselves, praise ourselves, credit our education, smartness, beauty, intelligence, and whatever. And when we set our eyes off him and start to look at other things, that becomes the time we start sinking in life. When you started the journey of faith, your eyes were on Christ, listening to the word of Christ, fixing your eyes on Jesus. Though you are not educated, you get a better job, you get married, you buy a good car, you build a house, your life changes. When these things occur, you now set your eyes off him and you begin to look at the materials you have amassed. You credit yourself, not knowing that this is the genesis of your downfall. The marriage, which was from God, crumbles. The job that is from Jesus, you now lose it. The good health, which is from Christ, you lose it to sickness. And you begin to live a miserable life. Because you set your eyes off the author and the perfecter or the pioneer of it. Thinking about a problem the whole day will never solve it. You can be thinking of your situation, your sickness. Instead, when you pay more attention to your sickness, you magnify that sickness. When you talk, you are talking the sickness, because your eyes are fixed on sickness, not on Jesus. The sickness becomes worse. The hunger becomes worse. Troubles in a marriage gets worse. Whatever disappointment gets worse, because your eyes are not fixed on Jesus, but on what you are going through. I want to implore you in the name of Jesus Christ to set or to fix your eyes on Christ, the author and the perfecter of it. God did not call us to look within ourselves and find the faith we need to overcome what we are going through. But God has called us to look at Jesus and get from him the necessary faith we need to triumph over what we are going through. From Christ, draw the faith you need. Not to look within yourself and find the necessary faith. Because faith does not originate with you. Faith does not start with you. You are not the author of faith. You are not the finisher of faith. You are not the perfecter of faith. Looking at yourself, you will only find yourself going from bad to worse. We waste our time looking at other things, looking at other people, looking at yourself, and you pity yourself. There is no solution in you. Solution is in Christ Jesus. Fix your eyes on him. When you are looking intently to the word of truth, this word, you are looking at Jesus. When you meditate with all sincerity, with all your heart on this word, you are meditating on Jesus. You cannot try to follow Christ in the absence of his word. Christ is the Spirit. The time we are now is calling you to look into the word. This is the time to invest on faith. To invest on the Spirit. In him, there is healing. In him, there is liberty. In him, there is deliverance. In him, there is blessing. In him, there is the prosperity you are looking for. You don't need to run from pillar to pole because it is in Christ Jesus. Look inside him. You will find your future. You will find your success. You will find your prosperity. You will find your blessing in there. In Jesus Christ's name. Thank you.